Installing an SSD or solid-state drive in your Dell desktop computer has many benefits over the older hard disk drives, like faster boot times. Plus, it's really easy to do. Here's how. But before you begin, there are a couple things that you need to know. First, if you have the install disks that came with your computer, the setup will be a breeze. Otherwise, you'll need to backup or clone your old hard drive. And it's always a good idea to make sure that your system BIOS is up to date first, so check Dell's website before you begin. Next, your work surface should be clean, and you should ground yourself first by touching an unpainted metal surface to prevent damage to any components. Now start by shutting down your computer and removing all the cables from the back, and it's important to remember where each cable belongs when plugging them back in after you're finished. If you plan on adding the SSD drive instead of replacing your old hard drive, you'll need an available drive bay, which should be easily accessible inside the computer by removing one of the side panels. And in most cases, you won't need any tools whatsoever to remove the side panel, because several computer manufacturers have switched to easy-to-remove thumb screws or latches. Otherwise, consult Dell's website before you begin. Once you get it open, you'll have a clear view of the drive bays, find the old hard drive, and you'll most likely find another drive bay nearby. And if you don't have a 2.5-inch drive bay available, you'll have to attach a bracket like this to the SSD to fit the larger 3.5-inch drive bay. Slide the drive into place with the SATA and power connector facing outwards where you can access them, and line up the holes to screw it securely into place. Now, locate an unused power cable inside the computer. Anyone will do, just follow the group of cables coming from the power supply until you find one. Or, use the existing power cable from your old hard drive and connect it to the SSD. Next, connect the SATA cable from the motherboard to the SSD. You can follow the SATA cable from your old hard drive to the motherboard to find an available SATA connection, or use the existing cable that was connected to your old hard drive if you're replacing your old hard drive. Now, connect the other end to the SSD. Slide the panel back on, screw it into place, plug the cables back in, and with that done, now turn the computer on and insert the operating system installation CDs. And when prompted, boot from CD-ROM drive. You can now install the operating system to the new SSD. Just be sure that if you left your old hard drive in, that you don't reinstall over your old hard drive, or you could lose all your data. And you might also have to change the boot order from the old hard drive to the new SSD before copying over your files, or after you've restored from a backup. And that's it. If you have any other questions or need additional help installing an SSD in your computer, be sure to visit www.kingston.com/support for more information. Thanks for watching.